Have you ever wondered why your computer seems slower and more cluttered over time? Well, it's time to tackle that issue head-on. Many of us believe that with the vast storage capacity of modern hard drives, a few useless files shouldn't be a big deal. However, that's not the case. Today, we'll explore why clutter can be a real problem. First, our device's increasing capacity needs to be considered alongside the ever-growing file sizes generated by advanced software, not to mention all the multimedia content we accumulate. This means storage space problems can sneak up on us sooner than we expect, and it's a good idea to stay organized from the start. But it's not just about storage space. Junk files can actually slow down your entire system. Think about the leftover dependencies when you uninstall an application. Then there are those temporary data files and cached remnants that serve no purpose anymore, not to mention the more sinister viruses hiding in the depths of your system. So, just like we keep our homes clean and sanitized, it's important to do the same for our computers to ensure a top-notch user experience. In this video, we'll show you how to declutter your computer and make it run better. We'll begin with the uninstallation of applications, some of which can be more complicated than they seem because they may not fully delete all related files, requiring manual removal. Next, we'll move on to a more comprehensive cleaning process, using two powerful applications, BleachBit and Stacer. These tools perform similar operations, but using them together ensures your system is squeaky clean. Finally, we'll address hidden threats with ClamTk, a user-friendly antivirus program. It not only removes accumulated junk but also protects your computer from future risks. So, get ready to optimize your computer's performance and keep it running smoothly, freeing up space by uninstalling useless apps on Ubuntu. Deb applications. One of the classic ways to install an application is by using the command sudo apt install application in the terminal. To uninstall it, we use sudo apt remove application. Be sure to confirm with Y and enter to proceed. Thorough cleaning. After uninstalling an app using the above command, it's essential to remove residual packages and dependencies. Run sudo apt auto remove, confirming with Y and enter. Then, execute sudo apt auto clean and sudo apt clean. Snap programs. You installed an application with the sudo snap install application command. You can easily delete it with sudo snap remove application. Unlike deb packages, snap uninstallation leaves no residue. Flatpak installations. Installing a Flatpak application involves downloading a file, double-clicking on it, and pressing install in software. To uninstall, restart this tool, find the application in the installed list, and click on the trash can icon, followed by uninstall. Ubuntu software. This tool is also commonly used for installing applications. Removing an app here is straightforward. However, if you installed an app in deb format, you may need to execute the commands shown earlier. GNOME extensions. While not exactly applications, unused GNOME extensions can still take up space. To remove them, open Firefox and go to About :Add-ons. At the bottom of the extension, click on Remove and confirm twice. The ultimate Linux cleanup tool, BleachBit. We often hear about CCleaner, a renowned system cleaning app, but sadly, it doesn't have a Linux version. So, we turn to BleachBit, considered one of the best alternatives for this task. It's user-friendly, customizable, and available in multiple languages. Installation. To install BleachBit, open your terminal and enter sudo apt install BleachBit. No need to confirm the installation, it's done automatically. You'll find BleachBit in Show Applications once it's installed. Starting as administrator. Unlike most apps, BleachBit offers two startup modes. To run it with administrator rights, simply click on the BleachBit icon as root. Permanent deletion. In the Preferences window, accessible on startup, go to the General tab. Check periodically for updates via the internet and overwrite the contents of files to prevent recovery for added security. Cleaning with BleachBit. Now, let's select what we want to clean. Choose a category from the list on the left. You can easily select or deselect individual entries or entire groups. Previewing items. Click Preview at the top to see the space that will be reclaimed. You'll find the number of megabytes to be recovered and a list of items BleachBit will work on. Initiating cleanup. Ready to clean? Click Clean at the top and then Delete in the pop-up window. Afterward, you'll get a summary of the disk space reclaimed, the number of files deleted, and special operations performed. System cleanup. In the system group, select items like clipboard, cache, trash, broken desktop files, temporary files, memory, etc. The memory option activates an experimental warning. Reclaiming free space. Within system, also choose free disk space. Be prepared, this operation can be slow. Click OK and then clean, followed by delete. Creating random garbage. For added privacy, generate random garbage data. Go to the upper right menu, select Make Chaff, and keep the default parameters. Click Create Files and OK. Covering your tracks. To ensure no one knows what you've done with BleachBit, go to the top right menu, select Shred Settings and Quit, and confirm by clicking Delete in the window that appears. With BleachBit, your Linux system can stay clean and optimized effortlessly. Give it a try and enjoy a smoother Linux experience. System cleanup and optimization with Stacer. Stacer is a fantastic application recommended for those with some Linux experience. It provides a range of tools that can be quite powerful, so beginners should use them cautiously. Alongside its classic system cleaning features, you can manage repositories, control startup applications in Ubuntu, uninstall packages, and close running processes. Stacer aims to be more than just a cleaner, it's a full-fledged system efficiency manager. Installation. First of all, open the terminal from System Application Launcher and type the following command to add the Stacer PPA to your system. Then, execute the following commands to install Stacer package on your Ubuntu system. Sudo apt-get update. Sudo apt-get install Stacer. Settings. In the left-hand menu, click on the settings icon, second to last from top to bottom. In the start page menu, choose your preferred start page. Dashboards. Explore the dashboards section by clicking on the corresponding icon on the left. Here, you can access information about your computer, from the operating system to CPU stats, RAM usage, and hard disk occupancy. Resources. This section allows you to view various parameters history, such as file uploads and downloads. You can also observe an animated graph illustrating your hard drive's partitioning. System Cleaner. In the System Cleaner section, select which of the five elements you'd like to clean with a single click. You can also click Select All to clean everything simultaneously. Cleaning Up. Click on the magnifying glass icon. In the window that appears, select items to delete with a single click, or press Select All to delete everything in the list. Then, click on the broom icon to proceed. Managing services. In the services section, you can enable or disable services for your convenience, such as Bluetooth. Each service has two switches, one for enabling or disabling at startup and the other for the current session. Closing processes. In the processes section, you can adjust the refresh slider to slow down the update rate. Scroll through the list of running processes and select one to close. Click End Process to finalize. Uninstalling applications. In the Uninstaller section, choose either packages or snap packages at the top. Select the items you want to uninstall, then click Uninstall Selected. Managing repositories. Navigate to the APT Repository Manager. Here you can enable or disable a repository using the corresponding switch, edit it, or delete it. You can also add new repositories using Add Repository. Stacer is a powerful tool for both cleaning and optimizing your Linux system. Give it a try, but remember to use advanced features carefully. Deleting dangerous files from your hard drive with ClamTK. Even though Linux systems are less prone to malware, there's no harm in taking precautionary steps. While browsing the web, we might unintentionally accumulate files that can hinder system efficiency or, worse, contain malware. That's where ClamTK comes in, offering active protection, scheduled scans, and manual scan options. It's the antivirus solution that keeps your Linux system clean without requiring advanced IT knowledge. Installation. To get started, open Ubuntu software and simply search for Clam. Click the result, then hit install. After installation, launch ClamTK from Show Applications. Settings. In the Settings section, you can activate heuristic scanning and analysis of potentially unwanted applications, PUAs. Once you've made your selections, click Back. Scheduled scans. Click on Scheduler to set up regular scans of your home folder and antivirus signatures. Click the sign to enable these tasks, then press Close. Excluding folders. If you're confident that a particular folder doesn't need scanning, use the whitelist option. Click Add a directory, select the folder, click OK, and then Back. Updating definitions. Ensure your antivirus is up to date by clicking on Update the Assistant. In the window that appears, select Automatically Receive Updates, press Apply, wait for the setting to activate, and then click Back. Analyzing files. If you're unsure about a downloaded file, use the Scan a File option. Select the file, press OK, and ClamTK will guide you on what to do if it detects an infected file. Analyzing folders. To check a group of files within a folder simultaneously, use the Scan a Directory feature. Click it and proceed as seen in the previous step. System-wide scan. To perform a scan of your entire operating system, start with Scan a Directory again. In the new window, choose Other Locations, then Computer, and press OK. Viewing scan history. For a comprehensive report on your scan results, click on History in the main interface. Here, you'll find a list of operations ordered by execution date. Reviewing scan details. Select one of the scans from the list and click View. A text file will open, containing all the information on the results obtained. Click Close and, if desired, delete to remove the report. That's it! With ClamTK, you can ensure your Linux system stays clean and secure. If you found this video helpful, please don't forget to like and subscribe for more Linux tips and tutorials. Thanks for watching!